24 seconds of the second, a TKO. And right now we will have a world championship fight coming up. And it is the WIBC, the Women's Super Welterweight Championship. And entering will be the welterweight champ, Mary Ann Almaguer, and her opponent from France, Valerie Weiss. And this is Valerie right here. Would you believe making her pro boxing debut and landing in the championship? And the reason for that is she's been a very successful kickboxing champion with a record of 34-5, 39 professional kickboxing fights. And they're including those in the records here, almost like in the NBA. It's with the ABA question of including the ABA records and statistics. And now from Midlands, Texas, Mary Ann Almaguer. Undefeated in 8 fights, 6 with knockouts. And she is a brawler, always looking for the quick KO. She holds a win over Deirdre Gogarty, the young lady who slugged it out with Christy Martin. And we are getting ready to go. It's a scheduled 10-rounder, and up to Jake Gutierrez.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout is scheduled for 10 rounds, and is for the WIBF Super Welterweight Championship of the World. Introducing once again our referee, Mr. Frank Garza. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, she weighed in at 143 pounds, and she wears the green trunks. She is from Nancy, France. Her professional kickboxing record, 34 wins, 5 defeats, with 14 knockouts to her credit. Introducing Valerie Veit. And her opponent across the ring, she's fighting out of the red corner. She weighed in at 147 pounds. Her trunks are blue and white. She comes to us from Midland, Texas. Her professional record unblemished. 8 wins, no defeats, 6 knockouts. She is the current WIBF welterweight champion of the world. Introducing Mary Ann Gorgeous Almaguer. Scheduled for 10 rounds. They are 2-minute rounds. Mary Ann, who holds a couple of knockout wins over Helga Rozoy, one of the pioneers in women's boxing. And there is Weiss all over Almaguer, who was not ready for that. That is generally Almaguer's tactic.
Almaguer, the southpaw, she gets rocked and sent back to the ropes. Good uppercut from Weiss. Weiss is scoring in this first round. Better not kick. Almaguer describes her style as a southpaw keen technician. I used to be a brawler, but now I'm trying to use more technique. There's a good right hand from her.
You know what you can do with the technique today.
When somebody's throwing on you the way that Weiss is.
Almaguer also involved in some kickboxing, some experience, not as much as Weiss. They are going at it crisply here in the first. But remember, they're scheduled for 10 rounds.
Yeah, only 2-minute rounds, so they really started fast. Weiss describes her style as a boxer puncher. Her best punch is the right hand. She's naturally right-handed. And she likes the one-on-one of boxing and of kick fighting.
She's also an amateur wrestler, women's world kickboxing champion in 1995 from France.
Oh, she's pouring it on.
Almaguer bleeding from her mouth. She was not ready for this, did not expect it. Weiss making her pro debut after 39 pro kickboxing fights. and trying to walk out of the ring with the WIBC Super Welterweight Championship. And the blood is flowing now from the face of Marianne Almaguer.
Right from the nose, and then she ran her face into the face of Wheat. And Wheat gets a warning from Frank Garza for that. But it's Almaguer who's moving forward with her face.
And that is the end of round number one. And work to be done in this corner. That is the brother of Marianne, Adam Almaguer. Has a minute to stop that.
Oh, and that's so hard to stop too. A nosebleed, once you get hit in the nose and it starts bleeding, you can go on all night.
All right, now they're concentrating on the nose, not talking about now what adjustments do you make in round number two. You are in there against a warrior in Valerie Wheat.
Well, you certainly have to disregard the nose if you are Almaguer. You have to all of a sudden quit thinking about the nose as much as you can and get out there and fight. She was too tentative in that first round and allowed for Wheat to back her up to the ropes and to punch her. You're taught also to punch your opponent right in the face, right on the point of the nose. That hurt.
She has a little bit of, as you can see, a welt over the right eyebrow.
Yeah, and that was possibly from the two running their heads together. Just in the, almost in the center of the head, but just over that right eyebrow. Clean up some of that water in the corner and some of the blood over there in the corner. Got to wash that away. Done a nice job of cleaning up her face.
Straight right hand! And Almaguer is down! Almaguer came out looking to keep her distance and box a little bit, but it was the perfect distance for Wheat to unleash that right hand. Frank Garza making sure that Wheat stayed in that corner. And once again,
the second knockout. Valerie Wheat knows that southpaw fighters are susceptible to a real straight right hand, right down the pike, and that's just what she threw. It's still early in this round, too.
Three knockdown rule is in effect, and we have a minute 10 seconds still to go in the second. Valerie Wheat.
Valerie, you can't go crazy right now. You have to settle down and throw your punches real straight, try to connect again. Having your opponent down twice, you really have to concentrate and put her down the third time.
She just stepped back.
Well, she may be smothering her own punches, Valerie. She's on top.
And she gets a warning. And meanwhile, that just saves Marianne some vital seconds. 35 seconds to go in the second round. Can Marianne get out of the second round?
I know Wheat is really excited. Because of that, smothering her own punches, and they're going to pull a point from Wheat for tying up.
Well, meanwhile, seconds tick away. Yeah. We're down to 15 seconds left in the second.
Seconds of Almaguer here needed.
She's been down twice in this round. Also, you cannot be saved by the bell in any rounds. Almaguer survives round number two, but again, they're going to have to work on the ever-flowing blood. And there is Valerie Wheat. She does not sit down between rounds, uses the George Foreman approach. That is her husband, Orlando, in the corner with her, her trainer.
Thomas Ellis? No.
And, Orlando Wheat.
There is the straight right hand. B for victory from Almaguer. Right hand, right down the pike, try to bring a wide sweeping left hook behind her. Looks ice like pack on the forehead.
Looks, you know, like a romantic moment there in the corner.
Right there above that right eyebrow. You can see the swelling that we were talking about.
Ring card guy. Oh, he's helping the ring card guy. Look.
He's the one that needs help. She needs no help. Valerie Wheat.
All right, she put Marianne Almaguer down in the opening seconds of the second. Oh, Marianne! comes back, blazing here to start round number three. It's scheduled for 10. Still a long time to go. Marianne's undefeated record on the line, 8-0 with 6 knockouts. She's a potent puncher, but right now has been thrown off her game in the first couple of rounds by Frances Valerie Wheat.
She's getting her range now. Marianne, see her taking that half step back, resetting and unloading. She's trying to get Wheat to run into something.
Wheat to the black top and Alma Gare in the white. Alma Gare slugging. Hands up for Wheat.
Oh, nice jab. Alma Gare going downstairs to the body. Wheat tries to come up to the head.
Alma Gare. Oh. Wheat is down in the third. A dramatic part of events.
Bloody.
The count is 8. And she makes the count with 45 seconds to go. The crowd comes alive with this terrific comeback. A courageous Marianne Alma Gare, who has never tasted defeat, comes off the canvas to put her opponent down here in the third.
Yeah, it really looks like a different fighter this round from those first two. Putting more pressure on, throwing more hooks. Is Alma Gare and landing.
This is a Christy Martin type performance. Bleeding keeps on coming. And it's doing the show again, a women's fight.
Guts and determination. It looked as though Alma Gare was on her way to being knocked out. Final seconds of this round. A good round for Marianne Alma Gare. We had Valerie Wheat on the canvas.
Valerie Wheat goes to her corner, and there is Alma Gare. It's the same look in the corner, but a little happier at this point. Round four coming up, feverishly working in the corner. This is the knockdown in the third.
Putting the pressure on. You cannot stand out on the end of the punches of Valerie Wheat. She hits too hard out of the end. What Alma Gare did in that second and third round is pressed on the inside and then threw hooks once she got in there. Coagulant being put up her nose. When you got to cut inside your nose, first of all, it's hard to see it because you can't get to it. Unless you have like a light up somebody's nose to see where the cut is, and then get the coagulant on that cut is another story.
Second time! Round four.
Okay, round four. Who's round? Is this?
Get
that ice. That's Alma Gare again. Firing upstairs. There's the George Foreman defense by Valerie Wheat.
Pressure and hooks. And Alma Gare. Alma Gare cannot give Wheat room to grow. Oh, good right hand.
What a punch. Now blood all over the face of Wheat, but it is not her own. Marianne Alma Gare now qualifying for the cover of a wrestling magazine with that face, dripping with blood all over.
Yeah, no good. It's really fun about watching the girls fight too. They have something to prove. They come in with a fight plan, a game plan. They have styles. They try to figure out their opponents. There's a good 1-2 from Alma Gare. And Wheat comes back with a combination. That could be the Wheat combo.
35 seconds to go in the fourth. 27-year-old Alma Gare on the right from Midlands, Texas. Hitting a record with 6 KOs. She's 5'7", 146 and a half. Valerie Wheat, 28 years old. From Nancy, France, 34-5 as a kickboxer. This is her first pro boxing event. She has a little smile on her face now.
Smirk.
Yeah, she's 5'10", 143 and a half. Both fighters are stepping back. And that ends round number four.
round number four in a fight that has turned for Arianna Almaguer. They have to be happy with that round in her corner. She's smothering the punches of Wee. Moving on the inside, she's controlling the pace and the tempo. She's controlling the style of Valerie Wee. Now they just got to control that blood.
Well, if this were the Tommy Morrison fight, it would have been over a long time ago. Tommy Morrison coming up, his first fight in a year. And stipulation in that fight, that if there is blood, the fight will be stopped. He's going to have 1 minute to stop the cut. If it opens again, the fight would be stopped. So, new Tommy Morrison rule, at least here on the card today.
Oh, good combination.
But Almaguer, yes, we coming back.
But Almaguer using her force, moving forward. Can't stand out in the end of the punches. We will get you. We really has slowed down her attack, though. Looking to pose a bit more. Outside like this, sometimes you get a bit confused at that southpaw stance. And that may be what is happening to Valerie Lee just yet.
Almaguer has fought a couple of six-round fights. That has not gone past four. So she's fighting 10 for the first time. Consider the fact that Valerie Lee fighting for her first pro fight. And is asked to go 10 rounds, although she has the experience of 39 kickboxing fights.
Yeah, she started kickboxing in 1987 in Amsterdam. She was the 94 WKA champion of the world as a junior welterweight. So she's always up for a challenge, and she's got a challenge right now. She had Almaguer down two times in the second. She was down. Valerie Wheat.
Oh, Marianne walked into one and then gave one, two, three back.
Oh, watch the heads. Two of them coming together. Good uppercut and a smile from Almaguer.
The more she gets punched, the more she smiles.
Oh, boy, I tell you, they got to watch their heads. Heads coming together way too much.
Inside 10 seconds in the fifth. Scheduled for 10 two-minute rounds. WIBC. The women's IBC Super Welterweight Championship. And no, that is the blood of Valerie Wheat now from her nose.
Take a beating.
Say the women go out there, and we see this every time. Yeah. They go out there and fight.
They steal the shows, and here's why. Both of them landing back in that fifth round. Good right hook. And a right, straight right from Wheat. Almaguer, her favorite punch is the right hook.
The fundamentals are coming, but if they're not there, they go out, they give a tremendous effort, especially you coming off, you know, watching the Gastineau fight.
Yeah, and two, the thing about the girls is there is nobody really well-developed in women's boxing. Everybody's about the same, have been developed about the same as far as boxers.
Marianne.
From six.
Seems to have developed very quickly. Only eight professional fights. Undefeated. The southpaw, she does try to work that jab in. And has staged a remarkable comeback. After being down, looked to be out in the second round. Yeah, hitting down, the canvas twice.
Yeah, down twice. And really showing that she was on her way out. But then she came back. She wasn't even in the fight the first two rounds. And that third round, she really sucked it up and came back. And here she is in the sixth, pouring it on. She is pressing the attack. When you press the attack like she is and you put your power behind your punches, your opponent is going to go back to the ropes, which is just what Valerie Wheat did. And wisely enough, Almaguer used the jab from the outside.
These two showing more and more respect for one another here in the sixth. So much distance, having difficulty getting both of them in on the screen.
Yeah, but this is just what Valerie Reed should be capitalizing upon. She has Almaguer staying out in the end. Use that jab and set up that right hand. That's been her best punch. That's the punch that put Marianne to the canvas.
20 seconds remain in round six of the scheduled 10-rounder. Almaguer in the white top, Wheat in the black top. Oh, roundhouse right by Marianne Almaguer from Midlands, Texas, against her French opponent. Six down, four to go, and Marianne just getting into this now.
Some of that action from that sixth. Whack! Smacking left hand from Marianne Almaguer. Moving forward with their punches while Valerie Weed is moving backwards with hers. You get more force on the power of the punch when you move your weight behind the shot. Still trying to control some of that bleeding from the nose. In the corner of Marianne Almaguer. Jeff Ruff, boxing cut man.
Seconds up! Round seven.
Seventh round. Now Valerie Wheat must do something to turn the tide. By the seventh round, you realize the tenth round is not far in the future. And I have Marianne Almaguer winning from the third round on. She's feeling the effects of this hard match, and also the pushing and the pulling on the inside. The shoving, trying to force every shot. Both of these welterweights, when you go in there trying to force the knockout, trying to push it, it takes more energy. She's trying to relax as we.
Wheat, a statuesque 5'10", 143.5 pounds.
Nice and tall. The move tries to rein down her power. What you try to do is you punch down, try to put your opponent down to the canvas. She does a nice job of punching down with her right hand. Now turning to the southpaw stance.
Now another cut along the left eye of Valerie Wheat. Here's from this angle.
Really, both fighters taking their toll.
Almaguer just beating Wheat to the punch.
That's the face of the girl who has won the last, on my card, the last four rounds.
Well, the women now getting more TV exposure. That kind of scene in the corner does not look as far-fetched anymore.
It's a glamorous life. Look at this girl, blood out of her nose, her mouth bleeding a bit. Vaseline on the face.
Got the top, which we were describing as white earlier in the fight, we now have to describe as red to identify her.
Matches her gloves. Look at the Vaseline in her hair. That's the toughest thing after the fight, trying to get that Vaseline out of your hair. I used to have to shampoo 12 times and put powder in my hair. Try to get that Vaseline is the worst thing about the fight. cut, doesn't matter. Nosebleed, doesn't matter. The Vaseline.
Oh, swinging hard now. Alt Meguiar taking over this fight after being knocked down twice in the second round. Well, Frank Garza steps in as a mouthpiece. Marianne's comes out of her mouth. There is her brother Adam.
Adam puts the mouthpiece in, does a nice job of trying to wipe that blood away. You know, when a judge sees that red, red is a shock to the eyes. That's why all the stoplights are red. The stop signs are red. The red is a shock to the eyes. When the judges see that, they think automatically that somebody is hurt because they see that red. And you don't want the judges to see that red. Well, a good uppercut from Reed, but Alt Meguiar put the pressure on. When she got hit with that, she remembered that she has to go on the inside and force her attack. Oh, this is just guts and determination.
Alt Meguiar is still plenty in reserve. And she comes smashing out here late in the eighth round.
Oh, slashing his right. Big left hand.
Whiplash with that shot.
It looks even bigger with the ponytail and the hair of Valerie Wheat. One thing that's a bit dangerous about the hair, about having a lot of hair as a fighter, is when you get hit, it adds a bit more to the punch and it moves your head. Looks like it moves your head faster and harder, and you see the effects of it. Shot from Wheat. Marianne kind of dove into that shot. Trying to control the jab from the outside. A lot of movement this round from Alt Meguiar. Is she hurt? Turning her back. It appeared as though Marianne Alt Meguiar was ready to stop fighting right there. She turned away, much like Sergio Reyes did earlier tonight. Turned away and shaking her head no. Now if you're in the corner on the left with Valerie Wheat, you tell her, look, she's ready to go. Get right on top of Marianne Alt Meguiar. And if you're in the corner of Alt Meguiar, you tell her, take some deep breaths. Come on, she's going to be coming right at you. You stand up and start punching. Deep breaths right now. Ninth round, you got two more rounds to go. Scheduled for 10. Seconds out, says Frank Garza.
And this is round number 9.
Oh, and look at that. The end of the last round, Marianne is ready to stop fighting. She comes out with a barrage the first part of this ninth round. Wonderful job in 1 minute trying to get her ready to go again, ready to fight again, right to the kisser. Oh.
Valerie Wheat now with a comeback. Tommy Morrison is up next, waiting in the locker room. Like his first appearance in 1 year. Fight surrounded by the controversy of Morrison returning. And Alt Meguiar may have been poked in the eye. She is now turning away. She should just go down to the canvas and take it down, but Frank Garza stops the fight. Twists and turns. Valerie Wheat, who had her opponent, Marianne Alt Meguiar, down twice in the first, and Wheat knocked down in the third, with Alt Meguiar coming on for the middle rounds. But here taking control in the ninth, and Valerie Wheat, in her professional boxing debut, the former kickboxing champ, has become the IBC super welterweight title holder.
In her first professional boxing match, champion of the world.
And Marianne Alt Meguiar,
who went in with a lot to prove, and they duked it out. She's happy, a smile on her face. Valerie Wheat, and here was the end. Tried to quit,
Almaguer did in that eighth round. At the end of that round, she went back to the corner. They did a great job of reviving her. She came out with a barrage. When she stopped punching, Valerie Wheat poured it on her. And Frank Garza staying real close, but I've seen enough. Garza also knows what Almaguer was trying to do in that, at the end of that eighth round.
And Jake Gutierrez with the announcement.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 51 seconds of the ninth round, referee Frank Garza stops this bout for the winner by technical knockout and new WIBF Super Welterweight Champion of the World, Valerie Wheat. A round of applause for his opponent, former champion Marianne Gordas Almaguer.
The fighter from France is now a champion. And she goes home with welt under the eye, over the eyebrow, but with a smile on her face.
And the title belt wasn't free. She had to pay a price for it. No complaints from Marianne Almaguer, who came into this fight and gave it. Even all she got, she tried hard, but it was Valerie Wheat who gets the title belt.
And coming up, Tommy Morrison steps in the ring for the first time in a year, the first time since he has tested positive for the HIV virus.